So we are studying Rankine cycle. This is the most IMP cycle because it is used in real world. Okay, so in this, the diagram is like this. This is the pump. Okay, this is boiler, this is turbine, and this is condenser. Okay, so process starts here. This is the first point, this is second point, this is third point, this is fourth point. So in this, the process is, now we are studying on PV diagram. Okay, so this is the PV diagram. So now let's draw. Okay, so process is start here. Okay, so start here goes toward this, then it goes to third, then it goes to fourth, and again comes to one. So what is all about? Okay, so this is 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so what is this exactly happen? Now we will see here. 1 to 2, this is 1 to 2, this is pump. Okay, in this, pump is increasing the pressure from 1 to 2. Okay, after that, 2 to 3 is a constant pressure process, we will easily see here. Okay, after that, 3 to 4 is a decrease here, pressure is decreases. Okay, and some volume increases, only a little amount of volume increases. In 2 to 3, large amount of volume from here to here increases, and from 4 to 1 the volume is decreases. Okay, at constant pressure. So this is all about pressure versus volume diagram. Now we will study TS diagram. Okay, that is temperature versus entropy. Okay, so process starts here, goes to here, then it goes like this way, then it goes to here, after that down, and then here is first point. Okay, second point, third point, and this is fourth point. Okay, so what is it all about? So 1 to 2, here some temperature is increased at constant entropy. From 2 to 3 the entropy is increases. So in the diagram 2 to 3, here is boiler, so in this entropy is increases. Okay, from 3 to 4 is this at constant entropy, temperature is decreases. What is that? Here we will use turbine. Okay, 3 to 4, and 4 to 1 is a process. In this, condenser is used. So at constant temperature, entropy is decreases. So we will easily use these diagrams. So now let's consider that for wet condition. Okay, we know that from boiler to turbine, if the steam generated is wet, then this condition 3-4- in PV diagram, and for TS diagram, this condition is used. For dry superheated steam, 3 to 4, this is 3 to 4, this is 3 to 4 in TS diagram. In superheated, if the steam is superheated, now consider this 3-4, and here 3-4. So this is all about the diagrams of Rankine cycle. Okay, so let's analysis of Rankine cycle. Okay, so first one is that for process 2 to 3, okay, for process 2 to 3, that is boiler. Okay, here Q heat supplied is equal to H3 minus H2. okay, we will easily see that here, because of boiler, the temperature of the steam increases. Okay, second one is that process 3 to 1, here turbine work in this H3 minus H4. Listen, H4 is greater than H3, so we will take this. Okay, after that, third one is QR, that is Q rejected, heat rejected. This is the condenser process, and here the H4 minus H1. After that, fourth is pump work. Okay, so pump work is WP is equal to H2 minus H1. So in this, if we know that it is also be written as integration of VDP. Okay, now WP is also be written like integration of PB to P1 and dp is remain here. Okay, so next step is v p1 minus pb. So magnitude of wp, that is pump work, is equal to minus v p1 minus pb. Okay, so the v is specific volume of water. So the value of the specific volume of the water is 0.001 meter cube per kg. Okay, then we, if we consider pressure is measured in bar, if we measure pressure in bar, then the whole the equation is like this: 0.001 into P1 minus PV into 10^5, and that is joules per kg. Okay, then it will be first. So if you want it in kilojoule per kg, then simply it will be like this, divided by 1000. This is in kg, kilojoule per kg. Okay, so after that, we all know that if we calculate all this, okay, if we calculate all this, we simply get, because here is 10^5, the 3 zero is cancelled here and 2 zero is cancelled here, so all 5 is cancelled here. Okay, so W5 is pump work is written by like this: PB P1 minus PB divided by 10. This is kilojoule per kg. So this is most important equation here, so we will give it 1. Now for shaft work, the shaft work WS is equal to W of turbine minus W of pump. This is turbine minus pump. So for turbine, we will know that H3 minus H4 we will use, and for W, for pump, H2 minus H1. This is we will know. So this is we will say this 2. Okay. So efficiency of Rankine cycle. So efficiency of Rankine cycle is shaft work divided by heat supplied. Okay, shaft work is WS divided by heat supplied, that is QI. So shaft work from here, okay, H3 minus H4 minus H2 minus H1 divided by QI. This is H3 minus H2. Okay, so we know that if we want in different types, okay, so we will also write it like this: H3 minus H4 minus H2 minus H1 divided by H3 minus H1 and minus H2 minus H1. This is the final equation. Okay, in this, if we neglect pump work, that is pump work, we know that WP is equal to H2 minus H1. So if we neglect this, in this, this is cut down. So efficiency of R is equal to H3 minus H4, H3 minus H1. This is for neglected pump work. Okay, so this equation we will get. And last is the steam rate. Okay, steam rate is it is defined by 3600 by WS, and we will know that what is WS from equation number 2. So it is 3600 by H3 minus H4 minus H2 minus H1, and the unit of steam rate is kg, okay, plus divided by kg divided by Kelvin WH, that is kilowatt per hour, kg per kilowatt hour. This is the unit. Okay.